I want to try out Windows 11 and experience the future of Windows. But Microsoft are making such a fuss about not supporting any old computers. They are even actively blocking installation on PCs older than just a few years. Challenge accepted, Microsoft. I'm going to use my 15-year-old MicroPC, the Sony VAIO UX, because if you're going to bypass Microsoft's restrictions, why not do it with some style? Released in 2006, this little machine has become a classic. It has class and style, and I'm going to have to go full 007 to get Windows 11 to work. For motivation, I've watched a couple of movies that include this little VAIO. 007, Quantum of Solace.
Get Bond. Where is he now?
Approaching the docks, King's Quay.
It also helped defeat the machines in Terminator Salvation. This VAIO runs Windows XP like a champ on its Intel Core Solo 32-bit CPU. Make no mistake, I have some big hurdles to cross. First, 32-bit CPU inside simply won't cut it. That means I'll be taking this apart and pulling its heart out. If I can upgrade the CPU, then we can get on with showing Windows 11 who the boss is here. The two-handed mouse nub and mouse buttons, or the slide-out keyboard and touchscreen, all make for a cool little handheld PC. However, Windows 11 is a 64-bit only operating system. There is simply no way it can run on this machine. Fortunately, Sony released many model variations of the UX, with the final couple of models including the Intel Core 2 Duo CPU. This was Intel's first mainstream 64-bit CPU. I'm taking VAIO apart now to get to the CPU. I have here a replacement SSD and a mainboard, which we'll have a look at shortly. Okay, the first thing we'll do is take the battery off, and we'll have a look at the label inside, and we can see that this unit originally shipped with Windows Vista Business. Now there's four main screws to take out, so I'm going to start with those. Alright, that should be enough screws to get this thing apart. First thing to note is there's the SSD right there, and it's bare chips on a board, not even in a case. So I haven't taken any of the internal screws out yet, but you can see the whole internals are already pretty loose. And that's because Sony designed this so that the internal chassis was isolated from the casing, so that as the heat was generated, there were minimal contact points to transfer heat into the casing which you're holding in your hand. Most of the heat would have been exhausted out through the fan system. Well, that's already coming out. So there's the main board hidden, sort of sandwiched between all this componentry. Well, I'm going to start with the SSD. This must be a fairly early SSD, probably one of the very first consumer SSDs. All these chips, they just looked a little bit fat compared to the controller, but it looks like they're actually two chips layered on top of each other. I'll take the heatsink and fan out. I think that we've got four screws holding the main board onto the chassis. All right. It's just come apart. Oh, I see. This connector here is plugged into here, and that's what was holding it together. We've now got the two boards. These boards look pretty much identical. And the other side. So these are pretty much identical in every way, except the CPU is different. I'll put this board aside for something else. Okay, now time to get it together. Shouldn't be that hard. Just reverse the process, right? Famous last words. Well, I've spent some time searching around and I can't find my thermal paste. I mean, what sort of PC builder am I? So instead of thermal paste, I'm going to be using a thermal pad. Now, this doesn't work quite as well as thermal paste, but this is a fairly low power environment, so it shouldn't be that much of a problem. If it is, be sure to let me know. Okay, with the thermal pad on, just drop the heatsink back on. The old SSD had three screw holes for mounting. This one doesn't. I need to get the LCD plugged back in. It doesn't look like it's sitting right, but it's, yeah, no, that's how it was. And I'm just going to pop this in. I can secure that later. I just want to get this powered up and tested. Yeah, that goes together nicely. Okay. All right, screws in. Let's go. Right. Does this main board work? It powers up. Does it do anything else? Screen is white. Nope. Logo. Okay. And it's booting Windows XP. So obviously this has a Windows XP install on it. I'm not actually going to let it start up because I want to reinstall the operating system. Windows 11 has just been officially released a day early. The Windows 11 subreddit has lit up with posts and I have the ISO downloaded. I can put this straight onto a USB stick using Rufus and install from there, but I'm not going to do that. I have a better idea. Burn Windows onto a disk and enjoy the full vintage experience with true style and class. I'll be using the dock to hold and power the VAIO during the process. The ISO is too large for a single layer DVD, so I have Windows 11 burned onto a dual layer DVD plus R. I'm using my slimline optical drive, which I'm taking the cover off, to expose the disk as it spins during installation for that real visceral experience. Everything is set, ready to go. First signs of life appear from Windows 11. As expected, Windows 11 wants nothing to do with this 15-year-old computer. There are workarounds and I've started trying them. Shift F10 to bring up a command prompt, start regedit, and start adding registry mods. I found mods to bypass the TPM, the secure boot, the RAM, the storage, and the CPU requirements. But that isn't enough. Windows Setup still refuses to allow the installation. Again, I'm still unable to install Windows 11. Microsoft have put up so many roadblocks, I couldn't be sure which were stopping me. Even though I'm confident that the TPM and secure boot process have been bypassed, as well as the CPU, RAM, and storage restrictions. I'm now thinking there could be other aspects of this VAIO that Windows Setup simply doesn't like, such as the GPU or the screen resolution on this tiny screen. I have to go deeper. With VAIO in the dock, I'm able to plug in an external keyboard and really get to work. I found a forum post on the Windows 10 forums with a potential answer. Using the command line and Microsoft's own DISM command, there is a way to install Windows without using the setup GUI. The forum post describes formatting and preparing the drive using setup first, which I can't use. Digging deeper, I found this Windows Central article about DiskPart. I'm now using DiskPart to partition the drive and set it as active. I can format and I can assign a drive ladder all from the command line. If you're doing this yourself, the article is linked below in the description. I can now go back to the Windows 10 forum post and, starting from step 2, use the DISM command. I'm using the DISM command twice here. First, I'm using it to identify which Windows versions are stored in the ISO. In this case, I'm choosing the Pro version of Windows 11. Then, using the command again, I'm applying the selected image to install to the disk. Using the DISM command, I've been able to start the installation process from the command line. Now it's just a matter of time. I'm sitting back and I can see the disk spinning with the progress bar moving forward. This was one of my favorite moments of the whole experience. Once completed, don't forget to make the disk bootable using the Windows BCD boot command. It's in the System32 folder. And with that, the install is done.
To set up your device using a screen reader, turn on Narrator by pressing Windows plus Control plus Enter. For more accessibility features, press Windows plus U, or select the accessibility icon in the bottom corner.
I now have Windows 11 installed. Bypassing the online account requirement didn't work with Alt F4, so I plugged Ethernet into the dock to get past this screen and set up a local account. The question is, how well does Windows 11 run on the VAIO UX? As long as the OS is idling, it's okay. The big limitation is the 1GB of RAM in this machine, and there's no way to expand that. Performance Monitor shows the memory is just about all being used up by the operating system. Software predictably runs slowly as RAM is swapped out continuously. I did some before and after comparisons. The SSD is much faster on the new setup, while benchmarking is slower. These are not reference benchmarks. I'm looking at the relative performance of legacy tools such as 3D Mark 03. On Windows XP, with a score of 713, this is sort of respectable. The same benchmark on the faster Core 2 Duo CPU with Windows 11 yields a score of just 58. Windows 11 seems to use most of the resources on this PC. Kind of reminds me of Windows NT in the 1990s, a non-mainstream operating system best run on high-end hardware intended for future developments. I really enjoyed my first look at Windows 11. Now that I have a 64-bit VAIO UX, what's next? Windows 8? Windows XP 64-bit? Android x86 64? Or Hackintosh? If you've just joined us, you can share, like, comment, or check Patreon. You can also help by suggesting this video to someone you think might enjoy this. Helping just one person find this channel helps it grow. In exchange, I'm going to keep making the best videos I can. Thanks for watching. See you next time. Now let's go out with a bang.